es una chica muy nerviosa en el sentido de que se toma las cosas muy, muy, muy a pecho. Algunas veces su propia actividad intelectual o profesional o de activismo recae sobre su salud, porque no es capaz de marcar distancia entre una cosa y otra, y lo toma con mucho nervio, lo cual le acaba afectando demasiado, pero aún así esto le repercute en que desaparece unos días y vuelve más fuerte que nunca.
But Razan has always been a really dedicated activist for a number of different causes, but over the past year, she chose to go back to Syria and fight on the front lines for her country, and has put herself at a lot of risk for doing so. But she's fighting on a number of different fronts, but in, most importantly to me is her work in freedom, the area of freedom of expression.
Y aparte de su faceta como activista, como bloguera, Razan es una chica valiente, y con eso digo una obviedad, porque para ejercer cualquier tipo de actividad pública en Siria hay que ser muy valiente, pero es valiente aparte de ser una chica muy sensible, no solo tener una sensibilidad hacia las causas que defiende, sino es sensibilidad también ante el comportamiento de los demás contra ella.
With the absence of the international media inside the country, and with the absence also of the international organizations inside the country, then the center turned to be almost the only source of, in terms of organizational source, and like a media center source as well, that you can trust. A lot of international organizations and international press, they trust the center. It has a good reputation.
So I think Razan's biggest contribution during the uprising has been to raise the plight of bloggers and activists who have been arrested or detained for work that they've done both online and offline. So she's been very vocal in making their cases known and raising them not just within Syria but outside of the country as well.
There's also an untold number of people who've been arrested since March. One of the latest is an outspoken blogger named Razan Ghazzawi, who reportedly disappeared while on her way to Jordan.
Many people are tweeting with the hashtag #FreeRazan to demand the release of a Syrian blogger and dozens more who have been detained in recent months, according to Reporters Without Borders.
So the first time that Razan was arrested, she was frustrated that all of the attention was on her when other people were being arrested as well. But she speaks English fluently, she writes her blog in English, and people know who she is and they relate to her. And so even though the attention is only on her, I think that the attention that that has been raised around her particular case has done a lot to raise the attention of other people, other bloggers in particular who've been arrested as well.
Razan Ghazzawi had actually been preparing for this day. The web and social media activist, who uses a blog, Twitter and photo sharing site Flickr, had been giving her friends the passwords to her accounts so they could take them over if something happened to her. That's the picture painted on her online accounts. A tweet on her Twitter page says, "In planning for her arrest, Red Razan protected her friends. She can't give them the passwords they might torture her for."
Y aparte de eso, que fue para nosotros lo más chocante, era que nos estaba siempre diciendo lo que hay que hacer si la arrestan. Con lo cual es como que dirigió ella su propia campaña de apoyo para ser liberada, porque ella en este sentido no cayó en el chantaje que hacían contra familiares de presos, que era que como se sepa, les decían que como se sepa que está vuestro hijo detenido, o llega a la prensa o se hace una campaña, pues pasará más tiempo detenido. Ella no creía en eso, creía que había que visibilizar la causa, que era muy importante tanto para ella como para la causa de las detenciones ilegales que estaba cometiendo el régimen y que sigue cometiendo en este momento. Y para ello tomó esas precauciones que en algún momento para alguien con los que habló fuera era chocante, que alguien esté contando pues lo que quiere que se haga si la pasan a un calabozo.
Razan Ghazzawi was unique in many ways, but also in that she blogged and tweeted under her own name. She's not using an alias, despite the fact that it is extremely dangerous to be openly critical of the regime in Syria.
She has, you know, come back full force and been proudly using her real name. And she's, you know, really just incredibly brave to do that.
And Anas Katish, another Syrian, said on Twitter of Razan, "Razan inspired me not to be afraid of using my real name online when I was in Syria. Her courage is incredible."
Es una chica de principios muy fuertes, que es capaz de ir con ellos hasta donde sea, y creo que lo demostró. Ya va por su segundo arresto. Y que no es intimidable, o sea, por mucho que le pueda afectar una reacción de alguien, o los insultos, o las descalificaciones, o incluso amenazas, aunque le pueda afectar esto, ella sigue adelante y le da igual.
We opened the door, it was like they were full prepared. With weapons, formal uniforms, not all of them, some of them they were like wearing civilian clothes, and they just attacked the office, asking everybody like to give IDs, give up the cell phones, do not touch anything, write down the passwords of everything, and they wanted also to check right, like in the right moment, that if we were giving the right passwords or not, and they took everything, and then they took everybody to Al Jawiya, the air intelligence security. Razan Ghazzawi, she was calm, like nothing is going on, truly calm and strong.
I think that Razan and the Syrian Centre for Media and Free Expression and other groups like that are ultimately going to make the most impact because of the methods that they're using. They've been strong advocates of nonviolent resistance coming from within Syria, not from outside. And although we don't know what's going to happen next, I think that it's their work that will have the most lasting impact on society. I think just that, oh man. I think just that we miss her. I mean, she's such a, I think we miss optimistic Razan, because it's been so hard for her over the past months and nobody would blame her for that. But I think there was, you know, I mean, she's never been a happy-go-lucky optimist, but at the same time, before she had to deal with all of this in her own personal life, you could see that her strength came from some sort of internal optimism, even if she, you know, sounded angry on the outside. And I think that's, you know, I miss that.